Welcome to Master Chem Academy. Corbonyl compounds, question and answers. Today's our present session. First question, haloform reaction is not given by. So which of the following is not given all haloform reaction? So we know that what is haloform reaction? CH3CO containing compounds, if they are carbonyl compounds, they must have CH3CO group. If they are alcohols, they must have this group, CH3CHOH or CH3CO group. These compounds only give positive test for haloform reaction. Okay. So what is haloform reaction? So I will give one example, that is CH3COH plus 3I2 4NaOH. By heating, what it gives? CHI3 plus HCOONa plus 3H2O and 3NaI. This is the haloform reaction. So as it is iodine, so this is called iodoform reaction. And what is this compound? Iodoform. How can we identify this iodoform? This is a yellow crystalline solid. So with this color and crystalline nature, we can identify the formation of iodoform. Okay, so this is about haloform reaction. So if it is chlorine, what it gives? Chloroform, CHCl3. If it is bromine, bromoform, CHBr3. But chloroform and bromoform both are liquids. Here iodoform is only say solid, it is yellow crystalline solid. So which can give positive reaction for haloform reaction? If carbonyl compounds having CH3CO group or alcohols having CH3CHOH group, they only give positive test for haloform reaction. Now check out which of the following having either this or this group. CH3CO, so this is having CH3CO group, and next this is also having CH3CO, and next here this is having CH3CHOH. That's why, what is your answer? Answer C. So haloform reaction is not given by C6H5CO C2H5. So this is about the first question. Okay, now second question, which of the following does not respond to iodoform test? Okay, already we have discussed in the first question. So that is, which are having CH3CO group or CH3CHOH group, they only give positive result for iodoform test. So ethanol, what is ethanol? That is C2H5OH. C2H5OH means that is CH3CH2OH. Okay, and next A. And now what is B? Methanol, that is CH3OH only. And next C, what is that? Acetaldehyde, that is CH3COH. And D, acetone, CH3COCH3. And check out whether this are group, this or this group in the options. So what is it? CH3COH. So this is present. And next C, CH3CO group is present. Here CH3CO group is present, but which is not having either this or this group? So that is B. That's why, so this is the correct answer. Methanol, CH3OH. Okay, which of the following does not respond to iodoform test? So remaining all gives positive result for iodoform reaction. What is iodoform? That is CHI3. What is the nature of iodoform? It is a yellow crystalline solid. So except this B, remaining all gives positive result for iodoform test. Next, the third question, acetaldehyde and acetone can be identified by. So acetaldehyde, CH3COH, and what is acetone? CH3COCH3. So both these carbonyl compounds, so they can both can identified by. Okay, so here we know that the Lucas test we can identify alcohols by the Lucas test, not carbonyl compounds. So we cannot identify carbonyl compounds with the Lucas test. And Schiff's test, tolerance test, these are, we can identify only acetaldehyde. Okay, only aldehydes we can identify with Schiff's and tolerance test. Now what about acetone, both? So here both can identified by, what is our answer? 2,4-DNP. What is 2,4-DNP? So that is CH3COH plus 2,4-DNP. What is that 2,4-DNP? NH2, second position nitro group, fourth position nitro group. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. What is 2,4-DNP? 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. So this is called 2,4-DNP. Now here loss of H2O takes place. So here loss of H2O takes place, heating loss of H2O takes place, and what it gives? CH3CH double bond N, this one N, NH, here second position nitro group and fourth position nitro group. Okay, so corresponding to 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. So this is hydrazine, this is called hydrazone. Okay, 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine gives 2,4 corresponding 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. So this both can identified by 2,4-DNP. This is our answer. So move on to next question. Okay, next question, fourth one. Acetone adds up the following without the elimination of water molecule. Okay, without the elimination of water molecule. So from which of the following? So acetone CH3COCH3 plus NH2OH. What is this? This is called hydroxylamine. So hydroxylamine, so loss of H2O takes place. And what it gives? It gives oxime with the hydroxylamine. So the reaction, the compound is CH3CCH3 double bond NOH. This is called oxime. So as it is formed from the ketone, acetone, so acetoxime, ketoxime. So now, so what about this 2,4-DNP? So 2,4-DNP is 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. So this is NH2, second position nitro group, fourth position nitro group. What is this? This is called 2,4-DNP. So this 2,4-DNP, so with the CH3COCH3 acetone, so CH3COCH3. So here also loss of H2O takes place, and what it gives? The corresponding 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. Okay, so by the loss of water molecule. And next with NH2, same like this, similar to this NH2, so means directly, so this is NH2, so NH2. Okay, loss of H2O takes place, and what it gives? Corresponding hydrazine product is hydrazone, 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, corresponding 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone, here hydroxylamine gives oxime. So but without the elimination of water molecule, what is your answer? It is HCN. So that is HCN. Okay, now what happens here? Due to the more electronegativity oxygen, so the electron pair moves towards oxygen, and oxygen gets a negative charge and carbon gets positive charge. Here it is H plus CN minus. So CN minus attacks on this carbon, hydrogen on oxygen. So what it gives? That is CH3CNCH3OH. Whenever both CN and OH present on same carbon, that is called as cyanohydrine. What it is called? Cyanohydrine. So cyanohydrine is formed without elimination of water molecule. Here any elimination takes place? No, just it is a addition. That too, it is a nucleophilic addition reaction. What is a nucleophile here? CN minus. So nucleophilic addition reaction without the unlike to this remaining three, so without elimination of water molecule, the product is formed, that is cyanohydrin. Okay, next, move on to next question. Okay, next, which gives oxymes with acetaldehyde? Okay, so acetaldehyde, CH3COH. So which gives oxymes? So this is NH2, this is hydrazine. So what is the corresponding product? Hydrazone. Hydrazine gives hydrazone. 2,4-DNP gives 2,4-DNP. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine gives 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. And what is this NH2OH? This is a hydroxylamine. So this hydroxylamine gives NH2OH. So loss of H2O takes place, minus H2O. What it gives? CH3, CH double bond NOH. So this is called oxime. This is called oxime. So what is our answer? Third one. So what is the fourth one? NH2NHCONH2. This is called semicarbazide. What is this? Semicarbazide. So acetaldehyde with a semicarbazide, same similar way, loss of H2O takes place. And what it gives? Semicarbazone. Semicarbazide to semicarbazone. So this is about this fifth question. So next, move on to next question. Okay, next, sixth question. Which is more reactive towards nucleophilic addition reactions? So we know that carbonyl compounds characteristic reactions, whether it may be aldehyde or ketone, so both are having C double bond O group. Due to the more electronegativity of oxygen, oxygen gets negative charge and this gets positive charge. So there is more prone for the addition of nucleophile carbon or nitrogen nucleophiles on carbon. Okay, there is more probability. That's why nucleophilic addition reactions are more common in carbonyl compounds. So all these are carbonyl compounds only. So which is having more reactivity for this nucleophilic addition reaction? So for the, how can we say? So that is CHCOH having greater reactivity than, so here only hydrogen is replaced with alkyl group, and now if both hydrogens are replaced with alkyl groups, then so this is the reactivity order. HCOH has more reactivity towards a nucleophilic substitution addition reactions. So what is the reason why this is having less reactivity? The reason is due to plus I effect. Okay, we know that alkyl groups are plus I effective groups. Okay, alkyl groups are plus I effective groups. How many alkyl groups are there? Here two alkyl groups, here one alkyl group. Okay, with increasing alkyl groups, what happens? Plus I effect increases. And here what is the required condition? Positive charge on carbon. But what is the plus I group? What is the nature of plus I group? They can donate electrons. Okay, they can donate electrons to carbon. They can push electrons to carbon, electron releasing groups. That's why electrophilicity on carbon decreases. This is a desired condition. Electrophilicity on carbon is a desired condition, but that electrophilicity decreases with the increasing plus I effect groups. That's why this reactivity of ketone is lesser compared to aldehydes. Not only plus I effect group, and also we can explain with steric hindrance. Okay, we can also explain with steric hindrance. Here less steric crowding is there, but here more steric crowding is there. So if this alkyl group is also more bulky group, means in place of CH3CH2 propyl group, okay, so ethyl or propyl groups are there, then around this carbonyl group, so bulkiness increases, steric hindrance, that is called steric hindrance. Due to this steric hindrance, attack of nucleophile will become difficult. If steric hindrance is present, attack of nucleophile on carbonyl carbon will become difficult. That's why, so here these have less reactivity compared to aldehydes. So that's why what is our answer? HCHO. This has more reactivity towards nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, next, seventh question. Acetaldehyde cannot give iodoform test, Lucas test, Benedict's test, tolerance test. So already we have discussed this iodoform test. So CH3CO group, whichever having CH3CO group, carbonyl compounds which are having CH3CO group, they can give positive test for iodoform reaction. So that's why, so iodoform test, they can give iodoform test. And Benedict's and tolerance test, so this is also positive for aldehydes. Okay, they can give oxidation reactions. Okay, so this Benedict's and tolerance reagents, oxidizing agents, so they can react with acetaldehyde. But Lucas test, so this is your answer. So what is this Lucas test? Lucas test, this acetaldehyde, what is the question? Cannot give. So what is that Lucas test? So Lucas test is used for the identification of alcohols. This is important. Alcohols, for the identification of alcohols, Lucas test is used. So this is about seventh question. Now move on to next question. Okay. Next question, aldehydes and ketones give addition reactions with. So what are the given options? HCN, NaHSO3, CH3MgX, and all of these. So what is your answer? All of these. So here, so I am taking one example, that is CH3CHO, HCN, acetaldehyde with HCN, H plus CN minus, oxygen gets negative charge, carbon gets positive charge, so CN and H on oxygen. So what it gives? So that is CH3CHCNOH. What is this? Is called cyanohydrin. Cyanohydrin, acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. And what about NaHSO3, CH3CH double bond O, NaHSO3. So what is that NaHSO3? This is called sodium bisulfite. Sodium bisulfite. So what it gives? Corresponding addition product. So this is also negative charge, positive charge. Na gets positive and HSO3 minus. HSO3 minus. So what it gives? CH3CHOSO3H. Okay. OSO2H. And next here ONA. Okay. So this is sodium bisulfite. Sodium bisulfite addition product. Sodium bisulfite addition product. And next, what about this CH3CHO plus CH3MgX? So what it is? It is called Grignard reagent. CH3 gets negative charge, MgX positive. Here negative charge, oxygen, carbon gets positive charge. So CH3 on this and MgX on this. And next, what it gives? CH3OMgX. This undergoes hydrolysis readily. It undergoes hydrolysis, and what it gives? CH3CHOHCH3. What it is? Secondary alcohol. Okay, so aldehydes and ketones both react with all these and gives corresponding addition product. So that's why answer is all of this. Okay, move on to next question, ninth question. Ethanol and ethanol are isolated from their mixture using. So these are the given options. So what is ethanol? That is C2H5OH. What is ethanol? CH3COH. This is ethanol. Okay. So here HCN, this C2H5OH also reacts with HCN, gives C2H5CN. Okay. And next, this also reacts with phenyl hydrazine, C2H5NH, NH2, C2H5OH. Removal of HOH takes place and forms corresponding product. Okay, but not, it cannot react with the sodium bisulfite. Okay, but this reacts with HCN and also sodium bisulfite and also with phenyl hydrazine. Okay, so what is the reason here? Here it NaHSO3, it is a nucleophilic addition reactions. So carbonyl compounds, due to the more electronegativity of oxygen, carbon gets positive charge, then only addition reactions takes place. But here, this with ethyl alcohol can give nucleophilic substitution reactions. Okay, nucleophilic substitution reaction with ethyl alcohol with sodium bisulfate is not possible. That's why, what is our answer? Sodium bisulfite. With using this reagent, we can isolate ethanol and ethanol, so present in a mixture. Question: which reacts with both acetaldehyde and acetone? Okay, with the aldehyde and ketone both. So we know that failing solution, oxidizing agents, failing solutions, Schiff's reagent, Tollens reagent can only react with the aldehydes. Okay, with the aldehydes only. So this failing solution, Schiff's reagent and the Tollens reagent. Okay, but this Grignard reagent, what is Grignard reagent? That is RMGX. Okay, this can react with both aldehydes as well as ketones. So acetaldehyde and acetone both undergoes reaction with alkyl magnesium halide, which is called Grignard reagent. So what is the reaction here? If it is aldehyde plus RMGX or MGX, so here negative charge, positive charge, R gets negative charge, magnesium gets positive charge. So R on carbon and magnesium on oxygen. So what it gives? CH3COMGX, CHRH. Okay, so this readily undergoes hydrolysis, and what it gives? CH3. What is the product? CH3CHROH. What is this? Secondary alcohol. And next, what about ketone? CH3COCH3 plus RMGX. In the similar way, negative charge, positive charge, negative, positive. So here negative and positive on oxygen. So what it gives? CH3COMGX, CH3 and R. And next here hydrolysis. So what it gives? Says CH3COH CH3R. Okay, this is tertiary alcohol. Okay, with same Grignard reagent, so only acetaldehyde gives secondary alcohol, acetone gives tertiary alcohol. So what is your answer? Grignard reagent. The formation of cyanohydrin with acetone is an example of, so what is that? Nucleophilic addition, nucleophilic substitution, electrophilic substitution, electrophilic addition. So what is your answer? So it should be nucleophilic addition reaction. So with acetone, CH3COCH3, how the cyanohydrin is formed? Reaction with HCN. Negative charge, positive charge. So CN gets negative charge, hydrogen positive. So CN on carbon, positive carbon, and hydrogen on positive negative oxygen, OH CN CH3. This is called acetone cyanohydrin. What is this? Acetone cyanohydrin. So this acetone cyanohydrin, this reaction is, what is this? It is a nucleophilic addition reaction. Addition takes place. One is added to carbon and another one is added to on oxygen. So that's why it is addition reaction. Why it is a nucleophilic addition reaction? What is the nucleophile here? CN minus. So it is strong nucleophile. So CN minus attacks on positive carbon. So that's why it is nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, next 12th one. By which carbonyl compounds forms oxime? Oxime. Okay, what is oxime? So that is, so carbonyl compound with NH2OH, hydroxylamine. So hydrazine gives hydrazone. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine gives 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. And primary amines gives Schiff's base. Okay, here this is carbonyl compound. By taking example CH3COH plus NH2OH, loss of H2O takes place, and what it gives? CH3CH double bond NOH. Okay, carbon double bond NOH. This is called oxime. So as it is formed from acetaldehyde, this is called acetaldoxime. So this is about the 12th question, carbonyl compounds with oxime, formation of oxime with NH2OH. So this is about part 1 of question and answers from carbonyl compounds.